Hello everybody, welcome back to another AI video. In this one, we're in Photoshop. You'll notice that I'm in the beta right now, and I want to show you the new generative AI, or what they're calling Generative Fill. And even though it's in beta, it is absolutely astonishing. Adobe has really upped their game. This uses Adobe Firefly, so it uses their beta, their Firefly beta, and you're just going to be, it's just shocking how good this is. Let me show you some examples here. So the first step, if you want to get going and follow along, you need to have a Creative Cloud account, and you want to go over here to your left side under your Creative Cloud, go to Beta Apps, Install Photoshop Beta. Again, this is in the beta. Now, the second step here is I've just got this generic image loaded up here of a, looks like a boat on the sea, and I want a bald eagle right here, right? Like, let's just do it. So here we go. I'm going to go ahead and grab my lasso tool, and I'm going to show you how this works. So I'm going to go ahead and just draw something like this. This ugly little fill selection here. But when you do that, look at this. It says generative fill. I'm going to go ahead and left click on that. And now I'm going to agree to it, of course. And now I get to describe what I want. And in this case, I said bald eagle. Oops, let's see if I can spell today. And then I'm just going to go ahead and click generate. Watch this. This is bonkers. I'll come back when it's done. All right, here we go. So it generated a bald eagle out of nothing for me. And not only that, I can go ahead and make some changes to it. So let's say I want, you know, this looks good, but maybe I want a different flight, a different direction. I'm just going to click that, and there's another eagle. There's a good one. I like this one. This one looks pretty good. So there we go. I'm just going to give it a thumbs up. Why not? And that's it. We've gone ahead and generated and put a bald eagle into the image. Now that's pretty cool, but it goes a little further than that. Let's say I want to get rid of this up here at the top. I've got this little orange thing that looks a little bit like an aberration. It shouldn't be there. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the lasso tool again, and I'm just going to lasso around it, something like that. And then I'm going to click on this generative fill, and then I'm just going to say remove. I'll come back when this is done. Okay, so I've come back, and I mean, crazy, it's gone. Like, again, I'll give it another thumbs up, but this is amazing, this tool. Again, it's still in the beta, but what the hell, right? Like, let's see, here's where it was. It's gone. It's like, it's basically content-aware fill on steroids, but you can bring things into the image. You can do all sorts of crazy stuff. It puts it on another level. So if you want to take it, if you want to work on it, like let's say it's, you know, it looks good, but I'm going to go Command-T or Control-T to change the size because it's a little bit too big for this shot. I can go ahead and decrease the size. I can do all of these things. It's absolutely crazy. This is generative fill. That's how you install it. That's how you use it. It's nuts. Thanks for watching.